Okay, we are starting with the session. Before I begin the session, I would like to request all the participants to put your microphones on mute. Microphones, you can click on that microphone symbol which comes on your screen. Put it on mute. Also, if you want to save your data, you can put your camera also on off mode. Okay, to begin with, I welcome everyone, all the parents, students, and the rest of the people who have joined for this webinar. I welcome you all on behalf of principal, management, staff of Agnel Institute of Technology and Design. I myself, Lakshmikant Boldekar, registrar of Agnel Institute. I would like to give you a brief introduction, and then our heads of various departments will begin with their sessions. So many a times when we pass our 10th standard or 12th standard, the most common question that comes to our mind is, what are we doing next? What is our next step in our career? So always come in our minds. And that is why we thought of doing this kind of a webinar. We have done some webinar of this kind of technical sessions previously, but this is our first webinar of career guidance. So we thought of career guidance build for our students. Think of what we want to do in our after 10th standard or 12th standard. Many times we have heard that we need to look into what is our interest, so, or what is our passion. Now these words are a little bit hi-fi, as because the moment you pass 10th or 12th standard, you are not of that age you have through or seen life to that extent, and that is why we are here to help you out in choosing your career. So the question that remains is, what is, how to find out your interest? So you must have read somewhere or listen to in which they tell you that you have to question yourself to find out what is your interest. For example, if you are interested in some particular field, then you have to look into that direction. most of the times what happens is we look around our family background, we look around our relatives, what they are doing, our friends, what they are doing, and we tend to incline our career in that particular direction. And the main thing that remains is to look within you, what are you interested in? So that remains aside most of the times. Now, if you look at that particular question, how to find your passion or interest, okay, now what comes to your mind? Like, what are you good at? So this is the question that mostly comes to our mind. What am I good at? But mostly when you say, okay, I'm good at singing, or I'm good at dancing, or say cricket or something, then these are some fields which comes to most of the students' mind. What I'm saying is, our mind is like a hard disk, and we have all data that is gathered in our minds all the time through the experience that we get in day-to-day life. And when we ask ourselves what is our interest, the answer that comes from our mind is from whatever data that we have in our mind. Have you heard about something like, I am interested in some one particular game or one particular field which I have never heard about? This possibility is very, very rare, because something which I know already, only the answer will come from that limited set of data. So that's exactly where we are targeting it. So what is most important for a student from 10th standard or 12th standard, what is most important is to gather a lot of information, a lot of data with respect to various fields that are available, different avenues that are available, and then try to understand what is our interest. Probably you may say that, okay, I'm interested. You come to know when you gather knowledge that you are interested in, say, electronics. But previous to that, you never know what was electronics engineering all about. So now when you know that, then your mind starts thinking in that particular direction. So the first step that you have to do is to identify your interest, is look around you, start gathering information about different avenues what are available after 10th standard and after 12th standard, and then ask your mind the question that what are you interested in, and then see what is the answer that comes to your mind. This is the first aspect. Second aspect, which I find most important, is although we know that, okay, we are good at something, that is my feeling. What is the feeling of the other people around me? I may say that I'm good at singing, but many a times the friends say, you are not a good singer. So what is exactly required? So if I want to, so instead of saying I have a talent in something, I should be able to see that, what are my skill sets? How do I develop my skill set to become a good singer? Or for example, you like to play cricket. Just watching on the television about the cricket is not enough. You have to play, you have to go on the ground and play cricket. That is also not enough. You have to develop your skills. Suppose you want to change your what do you need? If you want to play cricket, say you require a good coach. Now, who is a coach? Coach is someone who is already successful in his life, or who has made successful cricketers in his life. So you need a good coach. Probably you need a good academy or an institution where this kind of trainings are given. So you need a trainer, you need a institution where your skill set will be developed. So this is the second aspect. Not just by having talent is enough, because you have to ask question now whether your interest can fetch you a living source for you, whether you can earn money with your interest. And there you will find the answer that, okay, to fetch me a living source, I need something like I have to develop my skill set. So these are the two things which I feel are the most important things when you choose your career. So first thing is identify your interest. To identify your interest, don't simply ask question to yourself that, because what answer that you will get is from the limited set of data. So increase the data that you have in your mind by understanding, by exploring different fields. And second thing is try to orient your interest towards your career by changing your interest into your profession, which will earn a source of life for you. So with this introduction, I again welcome those who have joined late. I again welcome them for this webinar. And this is the first attempt that we have done to this kind of a webinar. And our journey, Agnel Institute of Technology and Design, we have started in 2012 with a motive that par excellence is the sole goal. And we ourselves are teachers which are passionate towards our career of teaching. And we train our students to the best what industry requires. So this is, and from 2012 to 2018, we can proudly say that we are amongst the top most engineering colleges in Goa and in around Goa. So next session will be handled by Professor Amol Patil. So I request Professor Amol Patil to give you insights about mechanical engineering.
Thank you, good morning, all. Good morning, all students and parents who are connected to this online webinar titled Pathway to Success, Choose a Right Career Path. Now, I am Amol Patil. I am leading Mechanical Engineering Department at AIIT Dhaskau. Our Mechanical Engineering Department is a well-established department and continuously giving best results. We are having best equipped labs, and along with that we are having the teaching and non-teaching staff who are always working towards the betterment of students. This is brief about our Mechanical Engineering Department. Now, I am sure that many of us of you will have the question, what is the meaning of a mechanical engineering? Now, whenever we are doing some work, that is nothing but it is called as a mechanical. A work done with the help of a machine, it is nothing but it is called as a mechanical. Now, what is the meaning of engineering? Engineering is nothing but it is doing something which is artistically. So doing with the aid of a machine artistically is nothing but it is called as a mechanical engineering. Okay, so mechanical engineering is nothing but it is a branch of a science that is concerned with the design and manufacturing of the machine for artful working. Machine is involved in, actually if you see, machine is involved in the every aspect of the human life. Okay, so even a small machine is there, or whereas a complicated machine is there. Well, basic machine and a complicated machine. For example of a basic machine is nothing but a coconut de-husking machine. Now this machine will help in order to reduce the efforts. And a simple example of a complicated machine is a computer control lathe. Now this computer control lathe will help you to improve the quality of a product. This will help to increase the productivity. Okay, so now whenever I'm saying, now machine is nothing but something which will help you to do artistically. So now who is designing this machine? Machine is designed by the mechanical engineer. Now who is a mechanical engineer? The second question, obviously, who is a mechanical engineer? Now mechanical engineer is nothing but a person who studies this mechanical engineering course, a 4 years program, who is studying. He is nothing but he is called as a mechanical engineer. So if you learn mechanical engineering course for 4 years, the output what we get, it is nothing but it is called as a mechanical engineer. Okay, so now there are different aspects of this mechanical engineering. Okay, so it is not only designing the machine or developing machine. So first aspect is nothing but it's called it is a discipline, that is a thermal engineering. It finds application in various places, such as air conditioner. If you say the air conditioner, it is nothing but thermal and fluid engineering. A refrigerator, a fuel cell, or a power plant, steam and a gas turbine, all this will come under thermal engineering. So if you study some subjects like thermodynamics or fluid mechanics or HMT, which are there in curriculum, a person is able to work on this type of machines. Okay, so air conditioner is nothing but it's machine. IC engine is nothing but machine. So fuel engine, fuel cell, it is nothing but it is a machine. So this is the first discipline, thermal engineering and fluid engineering is nothing but first discipline of the mechanical engineering. Next is the machine design. So when you design something, for example, if you design a gear, you design a clutch. Okay, so this comes under machine design. Whenever we design some parts, that will come under the machine design. Okay, so when you study machine design 1, 2, these are various subjects which are there in the course. If you study this, then you are in a position to design some components. You are in a position to design a gear. You are in position to design a clutch. Okay, so this is the second discipline. Third discipline is a manufacturing or production. Now we know, for example, if you take the pharmaceutical is nothing but it is the industry. If you take a sheet metal industry, they are nothing but industry. So what is there? We are using something called as manufacturing and production over there. Okay, so this course, mechanical engineering course, will help you to handle such type of industry. A person who studies mechanical engineering course is able to work in such kind of industries. Next division is a automobile engineering. And next division or discipline of mechanical engineering, nothing but automobile engineering. It is a design of automobile, a full automobile. A person is able to design a full automobile. That is a automobile engineering. Next discipline is a mechatronics. Now, mechatronics engineering is a branch that clubs together three different things. One is a mechanical, electronics, and electrical, and a computer. Because nowadays there is a demand from the employer side to be multi-skilled. They want an individual who is having the different skills. Okay, so mechatronics is a branch that will have different skills are clubbed together, and what we get is a mechatronics engineer. Now, this mechatronics finds application in the robotics, it finds application in automobile, it finds application in computer control machine. So this mechatronics will have application in some recent technologies, some technology which involves the mechanical as well as the electronics. Now, student gain the mechatronics knowledge from the subjects like the DEMA, digital electronics, electric. So mechanical engineering, that is a discipline, that is a machine design. Now, a student can work in order to develop more efficient machine. If you learn mechanical engineering, then you can go for the research for developing the best machine. Next research is the thermal and the fluid engineering, where we can develop some efficient systems, innovative engines, engines which will consume less fuel, engine which will make the less noise. So this can be done. We can go for this type of research. We can go for the gas turbine research. Okay, next research is the manufacturing, a research which involves the development of a new manufacturing technologies which can be used in the industry. For example, suppose I want to improve the quality. Now, improving the quality in an industry is nothing but reduce with something or as a manufacturing. So people, we have to work for the reducing or improving the quality of the product. That is nothing, again, it is a research. Now, this is something about the research. The mechanical engineering student or a BE pass out, he can work either in a machine design, thermal, or a manufacturing field. Next, even after, if you don't want to work in the research, then you can go directly for the job. So various job involves as a design. You can go for the designing job. You can go for the development and installation of the mechanical component. You can go for a quality control, or the guy who will check the quality of the product in line in a organization. So this is one of the field. We can go for a manufacturing operation of the computer-aided components. Okay. So there are various jobs. There are the jobs either in the research in an organization, or you can go as a PhD. Now, next, you can go for higher education. You can go outside India for doing MS. Okay, you can go for a master's in various disciplines. So you can study in depth. If you are interested in thermal engineering, then you can study thermal engineering in depth. Okay, so these are the various things which can be done after B. Okay. So this is all about mechanical engineering and what is the scope. Yeah, now, thank you for patience listening. Now I'll hand over to Dr. J. Williams, HOD of ECE department.
Thank you, Professor Amol. This is Dr. William, heading the Department of ECE on behalf of Electronics and Communication Engineering and my faculty fellows. I welcome you all for this Career Connect conducted by AATD, and I'm going to present some insights of Department of ECE. So what is ECE? ECE is nothing but it has a two major, most happening entities of modern technology. That is electronics and communication. The demand for both of these has remained quite high in the last 10 years, and is expected to reach the apex within the next few years. So this is the reason why ECE graduates, they are finding more jobs easily in both the public and private sector. What is ECE? ECE is nothing but it is the utilization of science and maths applied to the practical problems in the field of designing of electronics and communication devices. So in this presentation, we are going to see what is the core domains you are going to learn in ECE, what are the opportunities, career and job opportunities in the private, government, as well as in the public sector. So before starts that, there is a technical slogan called "No world sans communication, no communication sans electronics." What is the meaning of it? So without electronics, there is no communication, and without communication, there is no world. In our day-to-day life, we are feeling the usage of electronics and communication. For example, I am showing two pictures. One is mobile phone, another one is car. The mobile phone, we know that it is because of ECE engineers, they developed that mobile phone. And if you want to communicate to other mobile phone, you have to use the communication technology. So this is the gadget we are using everywhere, everyone, and everybody. So the next picture shows that car. Normally, in two decades back, when you see that car, it is purely mechanical. Now, it is automotive electronics goes major factor in designing of a car. So many sensors are integrated in order to control the car. So wherever you go there in this modern world, revolving towards the technology-driven operations, so without electronics, you cannot think about anything, as well as without communication, you cannot think about anything. So now, why ECE? Here, I am going to give some aspects that why ECE is one of the most beneficial choices in the domain of engineering. So as I said, the two most happening entities of modern technology is electronics and communications. We are now living in the era of 5G with the motto of everything, everyone, and everywhere. That is, in the near future, after 2 or 3 years, when one completely 5G is deployed, you can control all things over electronics through wireless. So, and also, it has the sovereignty to drift between hardware and software field. And so, as I said, that there are a lot of opportunities. The ECE students can show the flexibility of choosing software and hardware field. They have a strong employment potential that they can go for a designing of devices, or they can go for a developing a software solutions and all these things. And another aspect is, as far as the earnings are concerned, the ECE graduates manage to grab a handsome compensation package starting of 3 lakhs on an average, and it can increase as the experience goes. So these are the four important factors most of the students, they are choosing ECE. So what are the core domains, what you are going to study is domain of engineering, what are the skills you are developing after completing the 4 years bachelor's course in ECE. You have a lot of chance after that. You can study your master and you can go for your doctoral degree as well as postdoctoral fellowships. And in the 4 years, what you are going to learn is very, very important for your next career. So in this, there are five domains, I can say that. First one is analog and digital electronics. In this, you are going to learn something on analog electronics and digital electronics, which is very, very important for that before 10 years or 20 years back, when you have a mobile phone, it looks like a very big, even in the initial stage, you have to carry a very big, less weight. This is because of VLSI technology. You can design a circuit which can occupy very, very less space, and you can test, and you have a lot of opportunity to work in this area, VLSI domain, testing, writing, coding, and solution architect. These are the very high profile jobs you can get if you are very strong in VLSI networks. The next, what are the career opportunities we can have in the EC department? I said that it has kind of a blend of hardware and software. You have an opportunities to work in the hardware domain as well as you have an opportunities to work in the software domain. In hardware domain, where you can work? You can work, it is again divided into three. One is they call it the design area. You can design, you can test, and you can develop a new product like TV, mobiles, and all these things come under this category, design category. And research, suppose if you want to develop a high performance computing, and if you want to develop a smartphones, and if you want to develop a program or protocols like in order to communicate the devices, this all come under research category. We have a lot of potential in India that we are having so many IITs, so many NITs, so many IISCs. So you can do your master and higher educations in this one. So next thing is the production. Production is which is related to that manufacturing and maintenance of various sectors. Suppose if you have a very strong skill of electronics and programming language and fundamentals of electronics and communication engineering, PCB boards design, then you can have an opportunity to work in manufacturing and maintenance in the area of cement factory, in the area of oil refineries, in the area of automation industries. You can work in a production department. When you see that software, these are all three high profile areas. You can write a code. You have to have the skills of understanding of electronics and the program language. So you have to write a set of commands, and you have to do a embedded programming in order to integrate it into a single chip. And also there is another area you can work it on, testing area. You can verifying logic. If you're having the skills of control system, hardware functionality, so you can have that opportunity to work in the testing area. You can develop a circuit and you can test a circuit by using the available skills you are acquiring in your 4-year PG UG courses. And the next important high profile job you can get it in the software is solution architect. In the solution architect, if you have a skill of logic and mathematics and programming language, so you can have an opportunity to work as a solution architect. You can give a solutions to the various issues which is related to the designing of circuits and testing of circuits and developing a communications between the networks. So these are the important career opportunities you are having when you choose that EC as a core branch. Then what are the job opportunities we can get? You have a lot of option. You can select a public sector, you can go to a government sector, and you can go to a private sector. Now I'll tell you how you will, what are the important private sectors and public sectors and government sectors are available, what is the mode you have to go for that sectors. Actually, when you go for a public sector, it is again two important domain they are working. One is hardware and software. In that, the production, which has the major important factor and area, which is work in, suppose if you want to work in Bell and NTPC, the production is the most important area you have to know. And design and research is another area which can have a promise of working in that HAL, BSNL, ONGC, SAIL, and Bharat Electronics. Whenever you see that the starting package for this type of public sector is from 50 to 55, and the packages increases linearly as your experiences is increases. The next area is you can go for a government factor. Government factor, mostly they are concentrating on design research area, not on the production area. Suppose if you want to go for Airports Authority of India, if you want to go for a ISRO, because now everybody, they want to go for ISRO. Suppose if you want to work in a defense DRDO, So you have to write there are two important comparative examinations. They call it GATE and IAS. Here also we in AITD we are giving motivations to the students to do GATE examination as well as to write IAS. And also if you want to go for National Informatics Centers, you have to have a strong skill and strong background knowledge of the domain. So here the starting package is around 40 to 55. As the experience goes, it linearly increases your package. It can reach around 2 lakhs per month. And the private sectors, here is the major people, they are going to this private sector. For example, with respect to electronics and communication engineering, they mostly goes to Nokia, Samsung, and Jio, and Qualcomm. These are the core companies we can get a chance to work in it. Initially, the package is very, very small. It is around 3 lakhs per annum. Then it is increases non-linearly depending upon skills you have developed. And even now, I told you that everything becomes now automation. Even car is also automation cars are also developed. Because of that, everything is controlled by wireless as well as the controlling of electronics. So here there are three sectors, which is simple. One is production, another one is design, another one is research. Wherever if you develop your skills, you can have a chance of working in that area. So why ECE at AITD? So I can say that why ECE at AITD? First thing is we have a very experienced and diversified faculty team. We are having around 13 faculty members. Average experience of 8 years. The second one is we are always giving knowledgeable and result-oriented teaching. The third point is I can say that core industry value addition, that skill set development. We are having two chapters for the students. One is they call it LP. IETE chapter, another one is we call it census. By using these chapters, it is all managed by the students with the help of faculty. They are organizing various skill development programs for the benefit of students. The next point is high placement records. So you will have this CIRC, they will give more information on what are the placements records of alumni. These are the four important factors that ECE at AITD. Next, another important thing is an engineering degree is a blend of theory and practicals. We are having an excellent lab facilities that we are having around 10 labs. That analog electronics lab and electrical lab, which cost of around 20 lakhs, we installed various equipments, CROs and spectrum analyzers and all these things in order to study the behavior of electronics and analog electronics as well as a digital electronics. We are having a signal processing lab with a sophisticated software, with the high-ended 30 computer systems with various digital signal processing boards, which helps the students to understand the skill of a signal processing. And we are having advanced communication lab with 26 lakhs of worth. We are having a various signal spectrum analyzer and advanced communication lab, and in that communication lab we are going to do various communication exercises, and you can develop a communication, you can write a program to implement the communication. And next one is instrumentation, automation and robotics lab, which cost of 29 lakhs. I have to start from the beginning. So instrumentation, automation and robotics lab, we are installing recent softwares and high level of hardwares in order to perform the instrumentation, automation and robotics experiments. And there is another lab which is called microwave and radar lab. If you want to perform the radar experiments, and if you want to do a microwave engineering experiments, you can do it. In all, total worth of around 1.4 crores we are investing for the benefit of students to learn more skills in the lab. So I can say the branch of electronics and communication engineering has got an enormous potential to match the future requirements of the markets. Hence, if you are looking forward to pursuing an engineering degree in ECE, definitely you can assure a lucrative career ahead. Thank you for watching. And now I welcome Professor Snehal to present their insights in the screen.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. Myself, Snehal Bogan, Head of Computer Engineering Department, would like to present to you all some insights of computer engineering. Just a minute till the presentation comes. Okay, once again, good morning everyone. Myself, Snehal Bogan, Head of Computer Engineering Department, will be briefing you all about the various career options in computer engineering and also giving you the insights of computer engineering. In this presentation, I would like to throw a light on some of the points, that is, what is computer engineering, what computer engineers do, the course, what are the topics that you're going to study in it, and what are the job opportunities available with computer engineering. Okay, so first let us see what is computer engineering. Computer engineering is nothing but the study that deals with the design, the implementation, and of both the processes, that is hardware and the software. Computer engineering is all about logical thinking, problem solving, and creativity. This basically helps you to set up frameworks and find solutions to different problems and the ability to invent new things. So once you have understood what is computer engineering, let's see the next question that comes to the mind, that is, what computer engineers do. To begin with, the computer engineers help in building the computers. Now, the computer engineers can perform research in building up the new computer devices or equipment, design, development, and testing of the computer systems, servers, chips, and assembling of the motherboards and electronic circuits. Computer engineers also can understand and analyze the user needs and recommend them appropriate software for their corporate or businesses. And one of the important things of computer engineer is that they can also help in building nowadays. Coming to the next field where the computer engineer can work is to build softwares. Okay, softwares play a major important role in our daily usage. Software is nothing but a code that will help you to build an application which will perform the requirement of fulfill a needs. Now, what is this software and what are the applications that can be developed using this software? All of you will use mobiles, so you can enter into mobile application development. You can do website development, e-commerce sites, like online shopping software. Then we can enter into designing, that is photo designing, paint editing softwares, into corporate businesses, like corporate softwares, which we have finance software, tally, tax softwares. We can build softwares in security, as if most of you all will be knowing antivirus softwares, which are used to protect your system. And very important is system software. So software engineers can also enter or develop new system softwares like operating systems, very few to name, Windows operating system, Linux operating system, Android systems, and many more. Coming to the next field where the computer engineers can work is animation or in computer graphics design. In today's world, you see, virtual reality and augmented reality applications play a very important role. So you can have a good career in this too. Game development is again another one where many of the people are interested. Then we have virtual effect design. As you can see, the movies, the virtual effects that are put, that is using animation. Next is administrator. You can work as an administrator, as a network administrator. Now, this network administrator plays a key role in implementing the network, managing the network by connecting all the computers around the world. Today, you can see me speaking to you. Okay, that is with the help of a network because the systems are connected. You can also speak to your friends, relatives, all those who are staying far places. That is because of a good network or connection of system. So all that thing is managed by a network administrator. We have the next opportunity, that is like a database administrator. So what is database administrator? All of us are using computers. We are storing a lot of data on the computers. We have your email accounts through which we get connected to our friends or to our colleagues. So this data is basically saved on the computers or on the servers or on the cloud. So the data has to be managed and organized properly. So the role over here is played by a database administrator who manages, maintains, provides security to our data, and also provides backup and recovery in case of some failure occurs. These are some of the key things which a computer engineer can do. Coming, if you have your dream to become a computer engineer, then what you have to learn? So let's see what are the things that you're going to study in the computer engineering field. So we few to mention. First of all, you have to know the different programming languages, or you'll be studying about the different programming languages. Basically, C, C++, Java, HTML, and many more. Apart from programming languages, there are some core subjects that you have to study. That is theory of computation, which helps, and compiler design, operating system, example, Windows operating system, how it is going to manage the various peripherals which are connected to your machine. So that has been covered in this particular subject. As said before, database management system, which deals with managing and maintenance of your data that is stored on the servers, on the system. Then we have network and security. Under this, we are going to study different types of networks, how to manage those different networks, how to control the traffic on the different networks, and very important, the security that is to be played when the data is transferred on the network. So how encryption of the data takes place. All that will be covered in network and security. Coming next to hardware and electronics. So over here, we have subjects like microprocessors, the processor, which is the brain of the computer, embedded system, VHDL, these are a few of the subjects to name, which deals with the hardware and electronics. Next, very important core subject is software development. How actually you start developing a software? From the beginning, the requirement collection from the user, till the final product, that is deployment of the software on the user's machine. So the entire process, how you go about designing, implementing, debugging, testing, and deploying of the software. So these are the few of the core subjects that you'll be studying under computer engineering. Apart from this, there are various revolutionary technologies that you'll be covering in this course. That is, you'll be studying about artificial intelligence, machine learning, cloud computing, big data analytics, mobile computing, multimedia systems, and many more to name. So these are a few of the things that you'll be studying under computer engineering. Coming next, once you have finished with your studies, then the next question arises over here, what are the job opportunities? So let's see the scope of a computer engineer, the job prospects for computer engineer. The world is booming for computer engineers. So computer engineers basically have very high demand in the market. There is a good salary package for the computer engineers. There is a freedom and flexibility. That is, freedom in the sense you can have good comfort environment, working place, you can sit in AC. Freedom flexibility also means that sometimes you have to work from home. You get that facility to work from home. No need to go out to the workplace and work. So that can be achieved. Easy to gain experience. And also you can be an entrepreneur and start up a new company. Job varieties. To name a few, I've already mentioned. Job type. That is, as a computer engineer, you can work under various fields. As listed, software designer, hardware designer, network designer, then database, DBA, then tester, data analytic, and many more, which you can see on the screen. The workplaces, it almost covers all the domains where computer engineers can find a place for a job. Software companies, hardware companies, banks, hotels, airports, publications, journals, hospitals, and etc. So almost it covers all the domains where you can find job opportunities. Apart from them, if some students are interested in research, then they can go for higher studies. When you're saying higher studies, the options available are, they can do Masters of Engineering, MTech, MS in IITs or foreign universities. They can further studies as PhD, or they can go for post-graduation. You can also get jobs in the research. You can get a research jobs in fields like DRDO, defense, ISRO, BARC, and etc. You can also get jobs under research and development centers in multinational companies. Apart from them, if some students want, after completing the BE, they want to go into management, then you can do MBA and PGDMA, post-graduation. Diploma in management. So these are some of the job opportunities that are available after computer engineering. So to fulfill the dream of a computer engineer, let's see what we deliver to our students at AITD. At AITD, at the computer engineering department, we are 13 faculties which are very experienced, dedicated, and qualified. We have good lab facilities. We have around 9 labs fully equipped with the latest computers. We arrange various workshops, guest lectures for the students with respect to the upcoming topics. We have student chapters. Under the student chapters, we organize various events and many more, along with technical and non-technical events. As an example of a computer engineer, a successful computer engineer, I have a student to present, Ms. Anusaya Vajji, who is presently working as a software engineer in Persistence Systems Limited, Vedna, and she is a gold medalist at Goa University. To end my presentation, I would like to read out a quote over here. Everybody in this country should learn to program a computer because it teaches how to think. This is given by Steve Jobs. And thank you. And now I would like Professor Prabhakaran sir to take over the session for project presentation. Thank you.
Okay, very good morning to all of you. Thank you, Snehal ma'am. So I am Professor Prabharan from Mechanical Engineering Department at AITD. I am here to give you some insights regarding project work that is being carried out in Mechanical Engineering Department. So let us just have a brief about what is the project work. So students of this generation are not new to project work, as schools nowadays are encouraging students to involve in project work at school level itself. But still, when it comes to a degree level, it is a requirement to be fulfilled for completion of your BE degree. Yes, you have to do a project work to get your BE degree. Not only that, it is a platform to put your knowledge into practical use and hone your skills. So your project work will be starting from your final year, that is your fourth year. So for the first 3 years, you will be getting into a lot of theoretical knowledge and little bit of laboratory work. But it is that project work that acts as a good platform to put all your knowledge and convert it to skills. And it is a testimony of your knowledge that you have gained in 4 years of studies. When you go to interview as a fresher, it is that project work what you have done speaks first. The question they will be asking is, what is your project work and how good you are at? So it is a testimony for your knowledge. Now, just to know about how do you do project, as we have a lot of school students as our audience, I'll just briefly go about how do you do this project. So first, you have to choose your area of interest and propose your novel idea for solving any particular problem. So once you there will be a professor who will be acting as a guide to guide you across your to the completion of your project work. So you propose your idea, then you have to do literature survey. So what is the literature survey? It is just to find out what others have to say about that. So you might think the idea what I have proposed is a novel one. It is an innovative one which nobody else has thought about. But you are not sure whether this idea has been tried out elsewhere in the world. So that's how we find out by doing literature survey. So there is a systematic way of doing it, and your professors will be helping you in carrying out the literature survey. So now you compare your novel idea with the literature survey, and then you find out the exact problem. Now you just refine your problem statement. Okay, now you have the problem statement, you exactly know what you are going to solve, and then you start designing your solution. And in case you are going to give a solution by means of fabricating a product, then you can design your solution by using CAD softwares or any other means. Then once your design or model is ready, then you can fabricate that product by using various manufacturing methods. And once your project is ready, you have to prepare a report of the project and you have to submit it. So this is how the project work works. Now, at AITD, we have certain criteria for selection of projects. We clearly make sure that the project work, what you do, does not add value to the student alone, but it adds value to the society as well. So when you submit your project proposal to the professor, he decides, he just scrutinizes it and finds out whether it falls under any one of these categories, whether it is industry-based project, or it is an environment-based project, or it is an agriculture-based project. So when it comes to industry-based, we see whether the project what you are proposing to do, whether it offers solution to any one of the industrial problems. So it can be in the form of designing a product or changing the layout, are carrying out some projects with respect to Six Sigma management, lean management, where we are trying to reduce the losses occurring to the companies in such a way. Or if it is environment based, whether you are trying to reduce or recycle the waste that is coming out of the society, is it focused towards something like that? Or if it is agriculture based, are you trying to design some mechanism or some equipment which will help the farmers to increase their productivity, and or any form of irrigation as such. So we make sure that whether your project falls into this, so that not only you are benefited, but the society also gets benefited. Now, under this background, I'll just like to show you some of the notable projects of our students. So this is a project called a semi-automatic roof cleaning machine. So this project is a mechatronics based project. So this project is designed to clean the rooftops for very tall buildings where human interference for cleaning the that particular space is highly risky. So this machine will and we having nozzles at this particular end, and it will be spraying water at high speed, and this can be moved up and down. Thereby, it can clean the rooftops and the terraces without human intervention. And this is another outstanding project, vehicle range extender. So our students have designed this project, wherein this is designed this hybrid vehicle. So this vehicle can be driven both by an IC engine as well as by a battery. So when you are riding your vehicle within city limits, where you need not accelerate so much, where you don't have the scope of going in the high speed, you can switch to battery mode. You can operate at normal speed, and if you are going to travel in a highway, you can again switch over to IC engine mode and you can travel at a higher speed. So thereby, this vehicle extends your mileage. This is one good project. And another project is patient transfer mechanism for a standard wheelchair. So this project was highly appreciated when this project went for the project competition conducted by GCCI in the year 2019. So this this attachment, which is attached to the standard wheelchair, wherein a patient can shift himself or herself from the wheelchair to the bed without the aid of a nurse or a helper. So that was this project. And this is a project which is taken up by the current current final year students. That's a deweeding machine. So this helps to remove the weeds that are present in the field, which will affect the growth of the actual plants. Okay, so this is a deweeding machine, and this project is also selected for the final rounds. And due to the present situation, the final rounds are not conducted. It's also a highly appreciated project. This one. And at AITD, we just don't stop by just completing the project. Once the good projects are identified, we also help them to convert the project ideas into startups. So that's what we aim at. So thank you for listening to the presentation. Now I hand over the session to Professor Komal for giving insights about electronics projects.
Thank you, Prabhakaran sir. Good morning, everyone. So I'll just brief you with a project of our department, that is a PV culture monitoring system. So basically, what we did in this project is, am I audible to everyone?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay. So this project basically. I'll just present the. So, in this project, what we're doing is the fish farmers, basically the Goan fish farmers, are breeding fishes, and they do manual testing of the ponds which are there, so which is time consuming and which is expensive. So what we planned on doing it is, we have designed a product which is having various types of sensors. So this is going to be embedded at the site in the various water parameters which are going to be there. They are going to be incorporated into the design, and this will be wirelessly sent to the fish farmer. So this product is going to be there at the site, and the fish farmer is going to be at his residence or anywhere. So the data, whatever data we receive from the product, is going to be wirelessly sent using cloud computing or IoT. This project is Internet of Things. It deals with Internet of Things also. So it is going to wirelessly send the data to the farmer on any handheld device, maybe a laptop or a smartphone. So continuously the data will be received by the farmer. And if any emergency is there, then the precautions will be taken by the fish farmer immediately. At present, many places in Goa, fish farming is going on, that is PC culture. What is PC culture? You breed fish or maybe prawns in a confined area. So you have a pond, you create a pond-like thing, or a natural habitat is undertaken, and you breed fishes. So presently, manual testing of the water, the various water parameters to regulate the fish health and fish breeding is taking place. So we have come up with a product which is going to continuously monitor the water parameters and wirelessly inform the fish farmer about the health of the fish is also about the water parameters also and the necessary actions you need to take. So with this project, we applied for a national level competition, which is Vishwakarma Chhatra Awards. So across India, around 1,476 colleges or groups had participated. And after that, there was a scrutiny of postage. So our college got qualified for the final round, the national level competition, which was at the AICTE headquarters, New Delhi. So this competition, initially 1,496 teams all across India participated, and our college was first to represent Goa at National Level Chhatra Vishwakarma Awards 2019. So at the final round, only 117 teams across India qualified. So our college was the first to represent Goa at the national level competition. At the national level competition of Vishwakarma Awards. Okay, now I'll hand over the session to Professor Kedar of Computer Department. Thank you.
Yeah, so good afternoon, everybody. Just one second. So is the screen visible? Okay, so as a part of final year project under computer engineering, we have taken a range of projects under software, hardware, you can say. So I'll just, instead of reading everything, just most, I can say, highlighted projects I would like to go through. We have done a range of projects like software, hardware. Under software, you must have heard about so many different technologies, so many different areas like artificial intelligence, data mining, then the new techniques like blockchain, augmented reality. So initially we were only focusing on the research-based projects, but later on we allowed the students to do a range of projects under software and hardware category. So under this 13-17 batch, the most highlighted projects were energy conservation by automatic equipment control using personal presence detection, then plagiarism detection using some algorithm, predicting students' performance based on some algorithms, then statistical stammer for Roman Konkani, and it goes on. So later on, the next batch conducted another several projects. Most highlighted were audio steganography with enhanced security using cryptography, leukemia prediction using random forest, blood group detection using image processing, weather analysis using Twitter data. So we allowed the students to do research-based projects which could be used in real life. The 15-19 batch did some projects which uses blockchain technologies. So digital voting using blockchain, smart walking stick for visually impaired, e-tendering using blockchain, marksheet verification using blockchain. This online product review classification project got published in IEEE. So that it was of that level project, smart parking system, automated hydroponic systems. So rather than showing you in the form of text, I would like to give you insights about all these projects in the form of pictures like this. Automated hydroponic system. This project was basically done for cultivating some plants inside a closed room. Then you can see this intelligent level in video game. This is a current students undertaken project, which automatically allows the animates as well as the person who is playing to change the levels. Rather than only playing the difficult levels, it allows him to either go to a higher level automatically or come down to a lower level. Then human guiding intelligent trolley, which basically guides the human being in a mall, giving the directions about different products wherever they are there. Then woman safety ring, from the point of view of safety of a woman, this woman safety ring project has been undertaken by again current this year's students. Then health monitoring and tracking system for animals, especially for a dog, they have come up with this, which tracks the health of a dog and give all the parameters back onto the mobile of the owner. Then this portable obstacle detection system for visually impaired, again for visually impaired people, it's like you can say specs which tells in the direction as well as some obstacles whichever are there. Then product visualization is in augmented reality. So augmented reality is a new upcoming technology which many of you must have heard about. So they have, students have even explored this area. Okay, so next I would like to show you a small clipping of a project which is nothing but smart walking stick under GCCI last year across five engineering colleges. Around 150 projects were there, out of which this project got second prize. So I would just like to show you a small clip. It detects the upper steps, lower steps. It allows you to detect water. These are the emergency messages that are being sent. So this basically navigates him. SPG. Okay, so with this, I will hand over the session to our training and placement officer, Professor Srinivas Joshi. Thank you.
Thank you, Kedar. Yeah, so I'm Professor Srinivas Joshi, heading Corporate Institute Relationship Cell, which is also called as CIRC, and most of the other colleges, it is called as Training and Placement Office. So there are various activities that we do under this particular cell. First main activity is placement, that is getting various companies to the campus and placing our students. Second activity is internships, to provide internships to our students in various companies across Goa and outside Goa also. That is, some students have also done some internships abroad. Then we every year organize a colloquium, that is Industry Academia Meet, wherein we call industry experts and they interact with our students, which we held every year. Then we are connected to our all the students, that is pass outs as well as present through WhatsApp groups, and lot of job opportunities also are passed on to us from our pass out students, which is helpful for us in placing our current students. As all the HODs have given various domains, idea about various domains that are in which you can work. Okay, this I will give you a statistics of our placements for last 2 years, and also which are the different companies that are visiting our campus. Also, along with placements, we do something called as pre-placement training, which is done in third year. Along with pre-placement training, we also organize a job fair. We have a CIBA in campus, that is Center for Incubation and Business Acceleration, which is basically for promoting startups. And we have our own e-cell, that is entrepreneurship cell, which is known as Institute Innovation Cell now. So with those two bodies, CIRC organizes job fair also. Then one more important activity is industrial visit or field visit or field trip, which we do for our students across all the years, so that our students get idea of various industries. Okay, and also what various expert lectures are organized. Okay, with the in association with different departments, so that we are always in touch with the industry through expert lectures, through field visit. Then two more things that we do. One is induction program. That is when first year enter, when students enter in first year, they are not aware of various things with respect to engineering. So we organize an induction program wherein we also call industry experts and various other programs that are organized for first year students to know what is engineering and what are the different things then they can do in next 4 years. Then we also look at transport facility, that is transport to come to college and go back to the home, go back to home. And we have buses flying from Panjim, Saprem and Mapsa currently. So I will just go through some placement highlights of this particular batch. We have got around 118 offers as of now, and around 72 students placed, with two students being offered as package of 12 lakhs by Jaro Education Company. One student is placed in Indus Valley Partners with a package of 7.52. And our 10 students are selected for Citrix Train to Hire program with a package of 6.5. Also, it is this year 12 students are offered by Persistent System Limited Verna, which is a great achievement this year, because last year we had around 7 students. This year they have hired 12 students. Various companies that come to our campus are Indus Valley Partners, Citrix, Persistent, TCS, Buoyancy Consultancies, Baiju, Capgemini, Sankalp Semiconductor, Wipro, IBM, Wiston, Mahindra, Kaineco. Okay, so these are and many others, and you must be familiar with many of the brands which are there on the slide. To know about the package, that is highest package in this particular case is 12 lakhs. Okay, average package is around 3.5 lakhs for all the branches. Also, to highlight something very important, that is eligibility. There is some of the companies, they say that eligibility is required, that is 60%. Some companies say that 55% is the eligibility to sit for the placements. And in this particular case, we are able to place 100% of the eligible computer students, 83% of the ECE students, and around 40% of eligible MEC students we could place in different companies in previous year. And this year we have placed, we have similar statistics, and still the placements are going on which were stalled due to COVID-19 problem. With respect to AITD, you have seen our projects, and various media houses and various newspapers have given coverage to our projects, because this particular projects are very good and they are well appreciated by the industry personnel. So various news and media has given coverage to all the activities that do that we do. You can see the petrols and electrical scooter, that is hybrid scooter, that is shown, that has appeared in Gomantak, that was shown just now. Then even the one project PC culture monitoring system, that also is appearing in the Gomantak Times. Also, other events that we are organizing are also covered by the news and the media houses. Also, you can see that in AITD student explore industries in Bangalore. So we have taken our students to Bangalore last 2 years, consecutive years, for field visit. Then not only Bangalore, but in Goa also, we have visited various industries like Kaineco, then Optel Vision in Verna, Go IT Hub, for different branches and across different years. Photographs of which can be seen on the slide, and these are the photographs of various placement drives that we conduct. We have a seminar hall, and wherein first the pre-placement talk is given. After that, there will be a test, online test, and after the online test, there will be shortlisting whose interviews will be taken. Also, we do in-house internships, photo of which is also shown there, and we do approximately 35 plus companies visit our campus every year, which is not less than any of the premier institution in Goa. Also, these are the some of the glimpses of industry expert talk that we conduct, and also the pre-placement training that we conduct. We have people visiting from TCS, Wipro, IBM, and all other industries. Okay, like Kaineco, then Paikane, and giving various talks to our student, and the interaction is continuous. Okay. So with this, I thank all of you, and we open this particular session for any of the question answers that you all have. You all can post your questions on the chat, or you all can ask us questions by unmuting your mic.
Thank you, Srinivas. I request the participants, if you have any queries, anything related to engineering career, engineering field, or related to our college, you can please ask. I request again, if anybody is having any query, you can ask, or you can, if you do not have any query, or if you feel that you want to contact us anytime later, you can visit our website, aitdgoa.edu.in, or you can mail us on a Career Connect, the same mail ID on which you have got the link for this webinar. On the same mail ID, you can revert us back with your queries in future.
I think there is one query, sir. Is there any program after 10th?
Okay, currently we do not have any program after 10th standard. After 10th standard, the student has to undergo science stream, 11th and 12th science. And then after science, that student has to answer GCET, Goa Common Entrance Test. And GCET forms are already available online. You have to fill the form, and then once GCET merit list is put up, it's a centralized process that is taken care by Directorate of Technical Education, and you have an entry to our college through DTE admissions.
Yeah, to answer this query again, after 10th, you can also join diploma course, and after joining diploma, after doing diploma for 3 years, you can join to engineering program in directly in second year. So we have some seats reserved for second year entry, that is lateral entry by diploma students. There is one more question, sir, that is, do you all have diploma courses?
We currently do not have any diploma courses in our institute, but in Goa there are various diploma colleges available wherein you can do your diploma in different fields. For more information on this, you can log into DTE website, wherein there are polytechnics like Panjim Polytechnic and all other government polytechnics available in Bicholim, in Kurcharim. So there you can do your diploma course, and then you can apply for direct second year degree engineering. Any other questions? Okay, if there are no more questions, I thank everyone for attending this webinar. It was nice interacting with you all, and I hope that you will carry on this information that you have collected today in your future. And if you are seriously thinking about engineering, Agnel Institute of Technology and Design, we are there here to serve you. Thank you.